I've gone through my CD collection and tried to group the ones that were around the same time frame of when I acquired them. During Nickelodeon's Slime Time, they would show little clips of different music videos, and there was one that they would show sometimes called One Voice by an artist who was very young. I don't know how old he was at the time, but he did a song called One Voice, and it was like this surprising song because it was like this really heavy topic. I don't remember if the topic was just anti-judging people or if it was about anti-violence. I don't remember exactly, but I remember it being really, really like a heavy subject material, and yet it was like this little kid who was singing it, which I think really blew people away. And he had this really lovely, pretty voice, and so it was like this really. It's this song that at first you're like, oh, what a pleasant voice, what a pleasant tune, but the song was so sad it like really hit you. And I got two of his CDs, Billy Gilman. Oh, I later got a Christmas CD of his later. But anyway, at the time though, I got. This is the one that has One Voice, but I don't think I acquired that first. I think I actually purchased this one first, Dare to Dream, which back then at the mall they had a CD store that would have the CDs in these special over cases because they were afraid of people stealing CDs, and it was like you had to go up to the register with something that weighed like more than twice this. I can't. There. Okay. So does this even have that? No, actually, this one doesn't have that. The funny thing about these songs, especially on this CD, but I'll get into that next. On this album, the Dare to Dream one, a lot of the songs, I don't know why this was, but I'm not sure if he actually wrote all of them himself. They were so very mature sounding lyrics. Like, you wouldn't expect some kid to have written these kinds of songs. Wait, okay. She's My Girl. I don't remember exactly how that one. Like, if there was anything that was. It kind of just. That one did sort of seem appropriate. Like, kind of seemed like a guy kind of crushing on a girl, young kid, boy. Our First Kiss seemed like a very surprisingly serious note about your first kiss. I don't know if he wrote these. I don't remember. Elizabeth seemed very serious. Oh God, I Make It to Summer seemed very serious. My Time on Earth was serious. You Don't, You Won't was really fun. That was actually one of my favorites. It was just you'd have to hear it. It was like fun. She's Everything You Want. I don't remember that one. God's Alive and Well. I actually don't remember that one. I don't remember The Woman in My Life. I think I remember Almost Love, but I'm not sure if I do. Then there's Some Things I Know. I don't remember that. Oh! And then 12 is Shamey, Shamey, Shame. And that too, like, I loved that one. It was really fun, but it didn't seem like something a kid would write. This one, though, I could be wrong, but I think that some of these songs are actually covers. So there's Little Things, which I loved. I Think She Likes Me, which was fun. What's Forever For, I think I liked it. One Voice, of course. I don't know what these asterisks are about. Oh, okay, these asterisks say who produced these songs. Spend Another Night. That has to be a cover, like, that's weird for a kid to sing that. Little Bitty Pretty One. I think that's not originally his song. The Snake Song. I Wanna Get To Ya. Oklahoma, There's a Hero, Till I Can Make It On My Own. Yeah, a lot of these songs, I loved them, but then I think it was like, I don't know if I re-listened to them as a teenager and was like, wait a second, this is weird. Like, did you really write these songs? I don't know. I don't think that some of these were written by him. So I don't know there. Okay. And I really didn't. I've never really, like, gotten into country, but that's, like, the closest I would say I ever got to, like, enjoying country music, if that's country. Because a lot of it is just so bouncy and everything.